Ever thought a simple can of Coke could catch a TV signal better than store equipment? Let's put it to the test. Let's start with something simple, the base of our antenna. Grab an empty Coca-Cola can, rinse it out, and make sure it's completely dry. Now, using a sharp utility knife or a fine hacksaw, carefully cut just above the curve at the bottom. Take your time here, the aluminum is thin and you want a clean, even edge. A little tip I've learned over the years, instead of forcing the blade, twist the can slowly while keeping the knife steady. It gives you a smoother cut and keeps the edge from bending. Once you've got the base free, set it aside. This little piece of metal is about to become the heart of our homemade antenna. Now take an F connector, the same kind used for TV cables, and fit it right into the hole we drilled in the bottom of the can. Make sure it's snug and centered. That's where the signal's going to flow in, so a tight connection really matters. Hey friends, let me know in the comments, where's your workshop located, city, countryside, or maybe the garage at home? Alright, let's move on to the signal core. This is where the magic happens. You'll need a piece of coaxial cable, the kind used for TV connections. Strip away the outer plastic jacket carefully with a utility knife. Underneath, you'll see a braided shield that's the grounding layer. Gently pull that back, and in the very center, you'll find a single solid copper wire. That's our main signal conductor. Now we're going to cut 5 short pieces of that copper core, each one slightly shorter than the last. The first piece should be about 3 inches long, then reduce each following piece by roughly half an inch. This creates a simple but effective gradient. It helps the antenna pick up a wider range of signals. Once you've got your 5 pieces, use a fine grit sandpaper or a bit of steel wool to clean each wire. You want them shiny and smooth. Any oxidation or dirt can weaken your connection later. Next, lay them side by side on your workbench and mark the center point on each piece with a marker or a light scratch from your knife. Those marks will help you position them accurately when we solder everything together. Here's a little tip from experience. Keep the pieces lined up from longest to shortest, left to right. It'll make it easier to identify them quickly once we start building the antenna head. Next, take the F connector and screw it onto the end of your coaxial cable. Make sure it's tight, you want a solid, clean connection. Then slide the cable's copper core through the hole in the can's base and secure it to the F connector. That's your antenna's main signal path, ready to power up. Now that we've got all five copper wires cut and cleaned, it's time to line them up. Place them from the longest to the shortest, just like steps on a ladder. Then mark the center of each piece, that's where we'll attach them to the main signal line later. Keeping them in order makes the next step a whole lot easier and helps your antenna work more efficiently. Now comes the most important part, building the heart of your antenna. Take the five copper wires you prepared earlier and place them on your workbench from longest to shortest. Each one will connect to the main copper core of your coaxial cable, right at those center marks we made before. Start with the longest piece first. Hold it steady against the coax core and touch the soldering iron where the two meet. Add a small bit of solder, not too much, just enough to make a clean, shiny bond. You'll know it's good when the solder flows smoothly and the wire doesn't wiggle once it cools. Then move on to the next piece, slightly shorter, and repeat the process. Keep them spaced evenly along the coax core like the ribs of a small fan. This spacing helps capture different signal frequencies more effectively. A little trick that improves reception without needing fancy gear. When all five pieces are in place, take a moment to check your work. Every joint should look smooth silver and solid. No burnt spots or cold solder. A quick wipe with a cloth or small brush will clean off any residue. What you've got now is the main signal element, five copper arms, each one tuned to catch radio waves and pull them straight into your TV. Simple materials, solid craftsmanship, and a bit of patience. That's how you make something that really works. Now for the finishing touch, connecting your homemade antenna to the TV. Take the other end of your coaxial cable and strip it carefully, exposing both the copper core and the silver shielding around it. Twist that shielding neatly so it doesn't touch the center wire that's important to avoid shorting out your signal. Next, screw on the final F connector, making sure it fits snugly and the copper core sticks out just a bit from the tip. A clean, tight fit means a stronger signal later. Every good antenna needs a solid base, something sturdy to keep it upright and steady. Grab a small rectangular piece of wood. This will be your base. Then take a round wooden dowel or rod and drill a hole in the center of the base just deep enough for it to stand firmly. A little wood glue or a drop of super glue will help keep it locked in place. Once the dowel is secure, use a bit of tape or a zip tie to fasten your homemade antenna, the can and wire set up to the top of the rod. Adjust the angle slightly until it stands straight and balanced. This simple wooden stand not only keeps your antenna stable, but also gives your DIY project a clean, professional look. It's practical, reliable, and built to last just the way we like our tools. Now that the antenna itself is ready, let's make sure it can reach your TV. No one likes a short cable that limits where you can set things up. So we'll build an extension using a regular coaxial cable. Start by cutting a length of coax that's long enough to comfortably reach from your antenna stand to the back of your television. Give yourself some extra slack. It's always better to have too much than too little when it comes to wiring. Next, strip about an inch of the outer plastic layer on both ends of the cable. You'll see a layer of silver shielding, twist it neatly to one side, Then peel back the inner insulation to reveal the copper core in the middle. Be careful not to nick that copper wire. That's what carries your signal. Now take two F connectors, the same type used earlier, and screw one onto each end of the coax cable. Make sure the copper core extends just slightly beyond the metal tip, not too long or too short. A snug, clean connection means less interference and a clearer picture once it's hooked up. When both connectors are on, use one end to plug into your homemade antenna. The other end goes into your TV's antenna input. This simple step gives you the flexibility to position your antenna anywhere, maybe near a window or higher up on a shelf, to catch the best signal. That's the beauty of DIY. You don't need fancy store-bought parts. Just a bit of patience, some basic tools, and a few minutes of careful setup, and you've built your own professional-grade cable connection from scratch. Now for the moment of truth. Plug your antenna cable into the TV's antenna port and turn the set on. Go to your TV's settings and start the auto scan or channel search. Give it a minute to run and you'll start to see those local channels pop up one by one. Not bad for something made from a soda can and a few spare parts, right? Clear signal, zero cost. That's the kind of DIY win we love to see. And there you have it. A working TV antenna made from nothing more than a soda can, a bit of wire, and some old parts from around the house. It's simple, it's smart, and it proves that with a little creativity, you don't need expensive gadgets to get great results. If you enjoyed this build, let me know in the comments. Would you ever try making one yourself, and tell me where you're watching from? I love seeing how folks around the world are keeping their hands busy and their minds sharp. Don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe for more clever DIY projects, and share this video with a friend who loves tinkering as much as you do. Thanks for watching, take care, and I'll see you in the next one.